Hey Hip Chicks, it is time for Caulky Talk, and I want to tell you why you should never waste your money buying a handheld tube of caulk. You see, there is an easier way to get your caulking projects done, and it does not involve this kind of tube. When you are working with a handheld tube, you are trying to squeeze the contents out. You're trying to direct it and control it all at the same time. And if you don't have really strong hands, it's even more of a challenge. So I say you ditch this tube and you grab caulk in a regular standard 10-ounce tube. Seriously, there is a right way and a wrong way to open a standard 10-ounce tube of caulk. But before we talk about that, I want to make sure that you subscribe. Click the button on the bottom and hit that notification bell too. Lots more videos coming from Hip Chicks. And next, make sure that you watch my easy bathtub caulking with silicone. It's getting a lot of traction. So let's talk about two things you need to know about a standard tube of caulk. There are two points on this tube that are sealed. A lot of people think they can just cut off the top of the tip, pop it into a basic caulking gun, and they're ready to go. But no, the tip is sealed as well as the base of the nozzle. And that's where the mistake comes in. So you're going to cut off the tip and then you need to puncture the bottom of the tube nozzle. But don't worry, your caulking gun has you covered. So guys, the $4 basic caulk gun is all you need. You don't have to buy any fancy products. $4 or less at your two major home centers. So when you buy a caulk gun, couple features you need to know. One is the plunger, it slides up and down the channel to push the caulk out of the bottom of the tube as you squeeze the handle. So you can have this style that just has a hook that you just pull, or you could have this style that you have to press this metal piece in and then you can pull back on your plunger. So as you can see, this is a very well-loved caulk gun, but again, $4 or less. Now with this caulk gun, I want you to take note right here in the handle. This is what is so simple about using a caulk gun for your caulk projects, is that right here inside the handle is a cutting blade built right in. So when you squeeze your handle, a little blade comes across and that's how you cut your tip. So you will take your caulk tube, you will slide it into the handle tip right like this, and you squeeze. And it will cut the plastic and a little piece will fall out. Boom, done. The tip is cut open. The other feature on the caulk gun that makes this so easy to do is that a spiking tool is attached to the caulk gun. You don't have to go looking for a tool that is thin enough and long enough to go into the nozzle to puncture the base. You don't have to look for a nail that's going to be too wide and not be long enough in the first place. The spiking tool is attached. So you're gonna drive this into the tube, you're gonna let it puncture the seal a couple times up and down, and then you'll just simply pull it out. You'll have some fresh caulk on the end and you know that you've broken the seal. Now, you can just flip this and it sits perfectly on the underside of the caulk gun so it's not in your way when you're working. Now grab your tube of caulk, pop it into your caulk gun, and you can just pump it a few times until the caulk begins to flow. And boom, you are ready to start your project. The beautiful thing about working with a caulk gun is that it will give you more control. You will be able to pull back on the plunger so that it stops flowing. You will get neater, cleaner projects every single time. But don't leave yet. I have a few tips on how to store your caulk and how to cap it so you don't waste any. Chances are you will not need an entire tube of caulk for most projects, but what are you going to do with the extra? You don't want it to go to waste because in 2 months you might need it. So make sure that when you are done doing your caulk project, you remove your caulk tube from your gun and you want to seal it properly. My favorite go-to is I will take a piece of plastic, I will even use a little baggie or saran, and I will put it on the tip and then I take an electrical cap. No need to buy fancy caps for caulking. I will use an electrical cap and I'll put that on there and I'll literally give it a little twist and the metal threads inside the cap grip the plastic. So now it is on there, it is airtight and you can store it. But when you store your caulk, be sure that you are storing it inside the house. not in a shed, not in the garage. It gets too cold in the winter and your product will freeze and then it will not be usable again. Now the other thing is to check the expiration date. Yes, caulk will expire. So there is an expiration date on the tube, and it's also a great idea to grab your Sharpie and write when you last opened it so that you know if it's been sitting on the shelf too long. So good luck with your caulking projects, and make sure you subscribe because we have more content coming every week.